I think Professor Gujjar, then we can start.
Okay. So welcome to all for this very important event on establishment of AS Arya Institute Chair Professorship. We have among us great colleagues and friends of Professor Arya and his family members. So like Dr. R.K. Bhandari, Sri Paritosh Tyagi, Dr. S.K. Thakkar, Professor Ravi Sinha, Professor A.K. Mathur, Professor Sher Bahadur, and then from his family, we have Dr. Rajesh Kumar Mittal, Mr. Arun Arya, Mrs. Poonam Agrawal, Dr. Subhash Agrawal, Mrs. Anshuli Arya, Mrs. Kausalya Devi Arya, and from our side we have our director, Professor Ajit K. Chaturvedi, and Deputy Director, Professor Manoranjan Parida. I am B.R. Gurjar, Dean of Resources and Alumni Affairs. So without taking much time, I would say a few words. This is great event in the sense because Professor A.S. Arya was not only alumnus of this institute, but also a big name in the area of his research, earthquake engineering, structural engineering, and he was the big mover to establish the Department of Earthquake Engineering in IIT Roorkee. He taught here for around 35 years, and because of his outstanding contribution in the academics and field of earthquake engineering and disaster mitigation and management, he was awarded with great honors of national and international repute that would be shared with all the audience during this particular event by the co-workers and his friends. So I request at first Dr. R.K. Bhandari, who has been a very close family friend of Professor A.S. Arya. He was director of CBRI and presently very active in Indian National Academy of Engineers and other national level bodies related to disaster mitigation and management. I request Dr. Bhandari to please give us a brief sketch of Professor Dr. Bhandari, please.
Thank you. Are you all able to see me and hear me?
Yes.
Okay. It's indeed a privilege. I thank my stars to have this great opportunity to be a part of this Punya Tithi, to pay my debt of gratitude and homage to Professor Arya. In fact, would not have asked more from the providence than this opportunity to be with you on this occasion. A lot has been said and written about Professor Arya. If you go to the internet, it is full of it. If you go to the libraries, you'll find papers after papers. If you talk to the students and the scholars, they will endlessly on telling you what he has done and achieved. I wouldn't waste my time on that. I also know that if you look at the contributions that he has made and the awards and that have followed him, that is also a very long list. And I think that most of you already know that. And you don't know everything about it. I also don't know everything about it. So, I mean, you share that kind of limitation. You may please see that. But still, you know, what I would like to tell you today is something which I have learned from him, and I would like that his legacy should pass on. What I believe in first thing is that of all I know and read about him, and my personal acquaintance with him for 45 years, minus of course 5 or 6 years when I was abroad, I can say that people of his kind will never die. In fact, people do die. All of us will have to go one day, but legends never die. And he was actually, as I described him, he was a legend in his own lifetime. Now, why I say so is because of my personal experience. It's not because of any load of emotion or what others are saying. So I am parroting their view. But what I would say is that when I worked with him very intensively, I don't remember the first time, of course, I met was in 1975, but my intimate contact and work with him started in the 90s or so. Actually, on one of the occasions when it was January 2001, a few days before the Gujarat earthquake came, we both were together in Chennai at the Structural Engineering Research Center. And I had lots of doubts. So I used to keep a small notebook and I will write a few questions. And then whenever we have time, we will exchange views on this. So I had about set of five or six questions for him. And one question was that, why is it that the institutional memories in our institutions are sadly lacking and the documentation is so poor? Because what I found him was a moving encyclopedia. You know, he was very deeply interested in how the earthquake engineering is developing in this country, how the course of practice are developing. And I only found one single point of attraction for him, in how we can use science and engineering to save lives. Every time he used to work on, I believe my all the expert friends who are here. So when this SERC event was taking place, I said that where do we stand with respect to the international standards and how is the development? And I was amazed that his memory was so magnetic that he started talking to me about 1962. And when the first code 1893 started, and then without any reference to anything, even now when I am talking to you, I am referring to a piece of paper where six or seven revisions were done, and he had the magnetic memory of this. And then it's not merely knowing about that, what led to those changes from time to time. So when I saw that kind of ability to express himself so clearly and about changes, it left me no doubt that actually he's totally committed to that cause. And it was about the same time that Indian Society of Earthquake Technology was established. He also established a PG course far back in 1963. Now, I would not devote time on it, but to take you straight to some of the things which needed a lot of courage. You know, he had a lot of courage to express things. And I was amazed that everybody, Ravi Sinha is here. He was part of many things. In fact, with Professor Arya and all that, we were doing the earthquake guidelines also in the NDMA and all. So when we were talking about this great earthquakes and 1905 Kangra earthquake, in 2005, they spent 100 years of Kangra earthquake, and everybody was fearing that that earthquake may come again. Nobody had any courage to say as to what kind of scenario would be there. Ravi Sinha did for Mandi earthquake much later, but in 1991, he had the census of Kangra, and he put his neck out and did some projections. And I have some figures here where he said that if that earthquake were to take place, M8 magnitude, 65,000 people will lose their lives and 4 lakh houses will be destroyed. So they were just not the numbers. He had a logic to accept that and had the courage to say it. Earthquake occurred in 1905. For 86 years, nobody worried about this projection. He was the first to do it. And I can tell you that now it is 2020. I have asked a number of people whether they have improved upon that projection, and I don't have the answer. Then, more so, he said that if at that time, when the earthquake resistant code 4326 had come and IS 13928 had come, he said only if 6.5 billion rupees could be spent at that time, the losses could be reduced from 51 billion rupees to 20 billion rupees. Now, why I'm saying this is, see the courage of putting the neck out, giving these figures, and then standing by logic. And the beauty of this is that even today, I see the papers quoting that only. So this is just one example that I've given you where this concern was there. Then, of course, in 2002, I think, what happened that he got Padma Shri. 1997, he got Sasakawa Award. But in 2002, I and he worked very closely together because Dr. Kakodkar was the president of the Indian National Science Academy, and this was the change of transit of this. At that time, an award was instituted, the Lifetime Contribution Award. And please read the letter of the president of the institutional academy which I've sent you, Dr. Mishra had written. That at that time, I had a long list because I was the foreign secretary. So I saw a very large number of galaxy of people, and everybody was top notch in their own right. But I'm very happy to tell you that he stood in competition of all of those, and he won the Lifetime Achievement Contribution Award in the year 2002. And do you think he shared with? It was Jamshed J. Irani, who is director of Tata Sons. And if I tell you that only 2 years back, Dr. Kalam had got that award, and 1 year back, U.R. Rao had got that award. So you can see that his weight of his contribution was felt as far back as 2002. Now, Ravi told in the previous meeting that one of the great things he found in Professor Arya is that he took science to the policymakers. Now, I think he's absolutely right, but I'll tell you more than that. He took science to the people. I think more to the policymakers, but he took the science to the people, because every time when I talked about him, he was talking about solving complicated problems by best use of science and technology in a very simple and practical manner. So he wanted to connect science and technology with the people. So this is another thing. Then science to scientists and engineers. In fact, that is the most difficult thing I have found in my life to do, because people have hardened mindsets, they don't change easily and all that. And then they have not short fuse, not much of appetite for scientific conversation and all that. And therefore, in such conversations, I was party to a number of them. I disagreed with him on number of issues and all that, but I found he was ice cold, never ever lost his temper. In fact, many of the people, they would leave the meeting, they will go on repeating what they have said. He calmly used to listen, and then he always helped the management in finding answers to this. So he took science to the scientists and engineers, and then not in the least, he took science to students. Now, this is a great thing, because I believe personally that he would be known for generations only because students are going to pass on that thing from like a baton from one generation to another. And this is where I feel that the great contribution of Professor Arya has come. I would not take much time, but just tell one more thing, which is which I think is very important, is that in the whole affair that was there at the National Academy or NDMA or NIDM, I actually informed everybody that this meeting is going to take place. I informed everybody that family is so enthusiastic. They have come forward. The director, IIT, and Professor Gurjar is putting all the attention to this and all. And everybody has conveyed to me, many of them over telephone, many by writing about this. I received, actually, as the director would tell you, a communique from the principal secretary to the prime minister. He wrote the whole page, and this morning I got a call to confirm whether I have got this or not. So this is one of the great tribute that he has captured the imagination at the highest level. I know that after Gujarat earthquake, when I used to visit Gujarat myself, he used to sit with Dr. P.K. Mishra in his office. So that is thing. Then I called General Vij, chief of the army staff, and who was actually the vice chairman, prime minister, the chairman of NDMA. He was vice chairman for many years. We were together. Ravi Sinha was also there at that time. And he has given a big tribute, and he confirmed to me over WhatsApp message that have I received his message on time. Similarly, J.C. Pant, he was the chairman of the High Power Committee, and we worked together in the year 2000, 2001. October, we submitted the report to the government. Professor Arya played such a major role that J.C. Pant also sent his tribute. I have passed them on to you. And finally, Dr. Kamal Kishore, he is a sitting member of the NDMA, and he has passed this. So I wouldn't take much of your time. There's so many to speak. But what I would say is that in the end, I salute Dr. Arya from the bottom of my heart. All my tributes to him. I respect their family very much, and congratulate them for this timely initiative. I will be failing in my duty if I don't thank Director IIT, Dr. Chaturvedi, for being so prompt. In fact, sometimes I believe, that it's only divine intervention that can bring about such rapid results. In fact, I believe in divinity, but in this case, I can tell you that the job normally I would take 3 or 4 days happened in 1 or 2 hours. So you can imagine that how fast it moved. I'm sorry I'm not able to thank you all, but my very sincere thanks and tributes on this occasion. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Bhandari. Thank you very much for sharing your thoughts on this very important occasion. One very humble request to all of you, because as you know, the legacy of Dr. Arya is so vast. We can go on, you know, for hours, and it will never end. But for the, you know, constraints of the time, we have to restrict ourselves to maybe 2 or 3 minutes so that we can get to know some very important or hidden treasures of Dr. Arya's life through you. So now I request Paritosh Tyagi Sahib. He is the classmate of Dr. Arya, and very close friend he has been to him. He was the chairman of Central Pollution Control Board also. So I request Sri Tyagi Sahib to please share his thoughts on this occasion. Tyagi Sahib, you have to unmute Tyagi Sahib, please. Tyagi Sahib, aapko unmute karna padega, please. Rohit, can you help?
No, it's done.
Yeah.
It's done. धन्यवाद डॉक्टर गुर्जर. ये बताइए मैं हिंदी में बात करूं कि अंग्रेजी में?
जैसा भी आपको ठीक लगे प्लीज.
तो मित्रों के बारे में बात हो रही है तो हिंदी में ही ठीक है. आपने बताया ही कि मैं उनका सहपाठी भी था और सहपाठी के साथ मित्र भी रहा. तो आज अपने मित्र को याद करने में खुशी और गम का एक अजीब सा मिश्रण अनुभव हो रहा, और मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि समय बीतने के साथ आनंद को याद करने में गम घटता जाएगा और खुशी बढ़ती जाएगी. हमारे बैच में कुल 52 विद्यार्थी थे, इसलिए हम सब एक दूसरे से परिचित हुआ करते थे. पर जब परिचय मित्रता में बदलता था तो संबोधन और भाषा बदल जाते थे, पर उनका इस्तेमाल सिर्फ आपस में होता था, औरों के सामने नहीं. यहाँ तक कि मैं कहना चाहूँगा कि भाभी जी को भी याद होगा कि वे टेलीफोन उठाती थी तो मैं पूछता था कि परम आदरणीय कहाँ है. खैर मैं अब आनंद स्वरूप आर्य के बारे में आऊं। उनकी एक विशेषता थी, उनकी मुस्कुराहट। विद्यार्थी जीवन से लेकर अंत तक वो मुस्कुराहट बनी रही, और ताज्जुब की बात यह है कि वो मजाक कम करते थे पर मुस्कुराते थे। और जब वो विद्यार्थी थे तब उनका व्यवहार वैसा नहीं था जो उस उम्र के लड़कों का हुआ करता है, इसलिए उनकी यारी किसी से नहीं थी। हालांकि जो उनके संपर्क में आया उन्होंने देखा होगा कि उनके वाक्य का पहला शब्द यार ही होता था। मुझे एक और बात याद आई, हमारे बैच में शायद वो अकेले थे जिन्हें 2.5 और 3.5 का पहाड़ा आता था, और उन दिनों कैलकुलेशन स्लाइड रूल से होती थी, पर वो बड़ी फुर्ती से मनी मन कैलकुलेशंस कर लिया करते थे। एक और बात जो नहीं जानता कि बहुत लोग जानते होंगे, रुड़की से पास करने के बाद IRSE के कंपटीशन में उन्हें रेलवे स्टोर्स के लिए चुना गया, उसे उन्होंने नहीं ज्वाइन किया। मैंने पूछा तो कहा यार रेलवे स्टोर्स में ईमानदार बने रहना बड़ा मुश्किल होता। तो कितने स्पष्ट थे, कितने सच्चे थे, कितने ईमानदार थे, ये इससे मिलता है। मेरा और आनंद का संपर्क रुड़की के बाद भी बना रहा। बच्चों से हंसी मजाक, भाभी जी के आतिथ्य पाने के अवसर मिलते रहे। इंस्टीट्यूशन ऑफ इंजीनियर्स और इंडियन नेशनल एकेडमी ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग के अधिवेशन में भी हमें मिलने का अवसर मिलता रहा। मैं सचमुच समझता हूँ कि आनंद स्वरूप आर्य इस काल के ऋषि थे, सदाचारी और ज्ञानवान, और जो ख्याति और प्रतिष्ठा उन्होंने कमाई वो हम सब साथियों के लिए बड़े गर्व की बात है। शायद हमारे बैच में एकमात्र उन्हें ही पद्मश्री मिली थी, पर उससे ज्यादा जो उनके लिए सम्मान, प्रेम, आदर जो भी उनके संपर्क में आया उनके अंदर जो मैं देखता हूँ बहुत अच्छा लगता है। अपने इस मित्र की पुण्यतिथि पर मैं अपनी और अपने सभी साथियों की ओर से श्रद्धांजलि अर्पित करता हूँ।
थैंक यू त्यागी साहब फॉर योर एनेक्डोट्स एंड नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट डॉक्टर एस के ठक्कर हु हैज बीन स्टूडेंट एज वेल एज कुलीग ऑफ प्रोफेसर आर्य। Professor Thakkar received MS in Structural Engineering in 1966 and PhD in Earthquake Engineering in 1972 from IIT Roorkee, and he was faculty from 1978 to 2006. So during this, he got closely associated with Professor Arya. I request Professor Thakkar, please.
I was actually one of his first PhD students in Earthquake Engineering. And at that time, the registration was possible because this was not a recognized branch. So we made a lot of effort that I got registered in earthquake engineering. In fact, but I ultimately could register only in civil engineering because the earthquake engineering registration was not allowed with one guide from civil engineering department and one Professor Arya. And he was my, of course, main guide. So I'm very happy that I'm able to say something about him and my association with him. Now, without this chair which is being instituted in his name, it is a fitting tribute to eminent engineer and academician who dedicated his life to the profession. And I had a long and thick association with him for more than 25 years. In fact, I first as a master's student in 64, and then a PhD student, and then a faculty colleague since 66 for a period of over 30 years. And we had together taught several master's courses, supervising master's thesis, PhD thesis, organizing specialist courses, earthquake engineering all over the country. We had the most valued research work done together in early 70s in the areas of dynamics of arches, shells and bridges, because these were his favorite subjects at that time, and it happened to be favorite subjects of mine too. Taught the master's courses, which were basically framed primarily on the basis of our joint research outcomes, such as vibrations of arches, gates and shells, earthquake resistant design of bridges and dams. Professor Arya spent most of his time academic life at University of Roorkee, now IIT Roorkee, and he was a sought after thesis supervisor. He was a very famous person, which students used to like him as a MTech supervisor or PhD supervisor in the field of structural earthquake in his early years. He was recognized as a great teacher whose lectures were always leave some lasting impressions of his subject knowledge on the students. He has lectured and taught earthquake engineering in several institutions in the country and abroad. He had taught and guided research at Institute of Earthquake Engineering and Seismology at Skopje. At that time, it was Yugoslavia. Now, subsequently, it was Macedonia. And since I also happened to go there, so he had created several fans which used to ask me about his and always about his research and about his well-being. He had authored several books on structural engineering. His book on steel structures was very famous, and he was known for his steel structures books in several engineering colleges and with engineering students and teachers. His masonry book on masonry structure was also very famous, and he has been author of several aspects of seismic guidelines of structures. One of the most popular projects on which he worked immensely after retirement from University of Roorkee is Vulnerability Atlas. In fact, he took a premature retirement at the age of 58 because he otherwise felt that he is very busy, and he maintained himself always very, very busy even after retirement. And this Vulnerability Atlas on which he worked is a very useful document for assessment of seismic resource structures. Now, he has numerous students spread all over the country and abroad who held very senior positions, and those who came in contact with him cannot forget his great technical capabilities as engineer, researchers and professor. He was a very rare person. He was a rare person who had deep insight of structural analysis, seismic behavior, structural design, construction aspects, soil and foundation. You will find very few people who have a grasp of all these things simultaneously. He has professional in the area of design, construction, advisor to several major projects in the country. He has been famous not only in the country, but almost all over the world. Whosoever came in contact with him in structural earthquake, he has been chair of several national and international committees and groups in earthquake engineering. He had very significant and important contributions in the founding years of the Department of Earthquake Engineering. He has been the recipient of numerous awards, national and international awards. His contributions in the field of disaster mitigations are valued world over. He had himself participated several earthquake in India and abroad. He had participated in Yugoslavia, and he was appointed as a consultant in North Yemen, in Sana, and he worked as a consultant of Government of India for 6 months. And he had been the chairman of CET 39 committees, and who has framed various seismic codes in India. His dedication to earthquake engineering, to non-engineer buildings, is very well known, and low-cost buildings and retrofitting of post-earthquake scenario is well recognized. Professor Arya had immense social connect, and he is the founder of the school in Roorkee, which is running very successfully, and he has been a world-renowned legendary figure in earthquake engineering. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Thakkar. Now I request Professor Ravi Sinha, who is professor in IIT Bombay. He has a specialization of structural engineering, and he has carried out several collaborative projects with Professor Arya. I request Professor Sinha to kindly share his thoughts.
Thank you. So it is a great privilege. Unlike most of the other people who are speaking, I was not a colleague or a student of Professor Arya. And still, I got a chance to be associated with him in so many different ways. So I always feel that I was very privileged. So I just want to share a couple of anecdotes. I first met him a few months after I came back to India and joined IIT Bombay as a faculty member. And before me at IIT Bombay, two really outstanding young people with specialization in earthquake engineering had joined as faculty members, Pradeepta Banerjee and Alok Goyal. So when I met him, I remember his first question was that now there are three people in IIT Bombay who are having specialization in earthquake engineering. Is IIT Bombay planning to start a new department in earthquake engineering? Now, I was totally taken aback because I had never thought of that angle. And as a young faculty member, I was not capable of thinking of that angle. But that was a theme of talk on which for decades we discussed, specifically with reference to the Department of Earthquake Engineering. So many, many times this issue was there. I used to tell him that we need to mainstream everything, otherwise the knowledge is not used in practice. And he would always say that, see, earthquake comes after a very, very long time. And once it affects any place, that area gets totally devastated. And that effect can last for generations and generations. So who's going to bat for earthquake safety if we don't have a specialized center which will be doing only that? So he had that perspective. And I think he used to look at Department of Earthquake Engineering from that point of view, that is there at least one place in India who's going to say that earthquake safety is important? And that is the only mission which that center has in seeing when it goes to the outside world. So so this is something on which we engaged and we sort of had to and fro many, many times. And he always used to tell me that, see, it does not mean that we are going to become safer against earthquake or something like that. But the thing is that if we don't talk about earthquake, then the seemingly big problems which are always there in the face of the happening, they are the ones which are going to consume everybody's time. And then this hidden kind of thing, which comes after a long time and totally demolishes everything in front of you, who's going to think about you? So that always used to make me ponder that, yes, I mean, this is an angle which I had never thought of. And this is the angle which he gave me the ability to think about by just questioning me on that again and again. So that is one very interesting thing I would like to share about him. The second is, it just accidentally happened that a few times we together did survey of earthquake damaged areas. Once was in Gujarat, once was in Madhya Pradesh, once was in Maharashtra. And it was just accidental that we ended up spending several days together doing these. And what I found really was that his amazing simplicity. So normally when you go to an earthquake affected area, the primary goal of the people who are survivors and as well as the government is to try to restore some semblance of normalcy. So nobody is thinking about a scientific team or thinking about some experts coming for some work and all. And it's actually not a fit in those areas at that point of time from either the people's point of view or from the government point of view. So in that case, how can we go about and do things which is primarily capturing highly perishable knowledge? Because if you're not there at that time, within a few days, that knowledge is not going to be available in front of humanity anymore. So I used to see that he would make a lot of effort to make himself relevant to both the people and to the government over there in a variety of ways so that they feel value in him being there. And that would also provide him the opportunity to do the other thing. So that is again something I learned by just looking at him, saying that if you want to do these kinds of very difficult job amidst great loss and mourning, then you also have to go out of the way, even if it's not your core work, to make yourself relevant, to make yourself useful, and to be able to provide the kind of assistance which you can only do based on the knowledge which you have. And that is also a lesson which has lived with me forever. And I have tried to use maybe unsuccessfully compared to how Professor Arya used to do. But it was a huge lesson. And I'm very, very fortunate that I have been able to get that kind of lesson. So I just wanted to say these two things. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Sinha. Thank you very much. Now I request Professor Ashok Kumar Mathur, who who joined the earthquake engineering department when Professor Arya was heading it. So he has also a long association, and he can share with us one or two very interesting anecdotes related to Professor Arya, please. Professor Mathur, please.
Thank you so much. I joined Department of Earthquake Engineering in the year 1976 when Professor Arya was head of the department. That itself was quite an accidental joining. I came to know that the position of a lecturer is available. I was a research scholar in mechanical department. Cycling, just saw the gate of earthquake department, entered Professor Arya's office, told him that I am so and so, good boy, M.Tech, first position, second position, distinction, so, blah, blah, blah. And he asked me to sit down, asked me a few questions on theory of vibrations, and told me, today is 26th March, can you join as lecturer on 1st of April? That's it. That's how I joined Roorkee University and now IIT Roorkee. That was a simple joining thing for me. I remember Dr. Arya on several things. That was a golden period of Department of Earthquake Engineering. 76 to 82 was a golden period when Professor Arya was heading. Immediately after that, there was a World Conference on Earthquake Engineering, which was held in India. That was the only World Conference held. It was a huge, huge event of the country, addressed, chaired by the President of India, Prime Minister Mrs. Gandhi, hosted all the delegates to her house, and wide coverage on the print media. Obviously, there was no TV media at that time. And Department of Earthquake Engineering was obviously, the Roorkee University was holding the topmost position everywhere. Everywhere was listening. During that period, if the word earthquake means IIT Roorkee University, any work on earthquake engineering means Roorkee University. Earthquake engineering was just in the beginning part of its, it has just started. And whether it's a nuclear power plant, whether it's a bridge, whether it's a oil refinery, think of any infrastructure, its earthquake resistant design used to come to us. Now, remember that those were the designs. We were having a faculty strength of 34. We had 34 faculty members, students only 10. 5 M.Tech students, 3-4 PhD students. So we had a 3-1 staff versus student ratio. For every student, there was 3 faculty members. But the amount of work that we have had, I don't recall any day in which I have come back to my home before 7 o'clock in the evening. From 9 to 7, we were all working. Dr. Arya was leading. It was a total professional atmosphere in the department. Dr. Arya used to lead the department. We used to have every 15 days a monitoring meeting. Every project used to be discussed, and its progress used to be, strategy for the next 10, 15 days used to be decided. And then we used to work in an extremely professional manner. Well, anything that we can surely say that Professor Jay Krishna laid the foundation of Department of Earthquake Engineering, but the Department of Earthquake Engineering was built, the major structure was built by Dr. Arya, and it is that structure in which we are still living together. And the Earthquake Engineering Department owes a huge, huge amount of, we owe a lot to Professor Arya for building it to the present level. Dr. Arya's personality was unbelievable. If there is a meeting, well, rest assured that it will be dominated by Professor Arya. The moment Professor Arya comes to the mic, when he finishes his speech, everybody used to be spellbound. And literally the meeting gets over, because anything and everything which was to be decided has already been come up, and there was nobody in the meeting who could have challenged him or who could have put anything suggestion better than that. Not one, several meetings I have seen where Professor Arya has totally dominated the similar scenarios. Similarly, in the symposiums and the conference, Arya Sahab agar aa gaye, to samajh lijiye ki us session ko to unhone pura dominate kar diya. He had a such a strong personality. I haven't seen a personality like Professor Arya anywhere. He was a great thinker, he was a great orator, and he was a great doer. And all, if one individual has, it was Dr. Arya. And with this, what I can say, I can only pay my homage to this great man. I only say that the chair which on which any professor will sit, he will always remember Dr. Arya and his cherished dream to have earthquake resilient society in the country. It will be taken care of, and IIT Roorkee will have a good name with this state. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Professor Mathur. Now I request Professor Sher Bahadur, who had a stint in IIT Roorkee at that time, and then he went to USA. He is living now in North Carolina. Professor Sher Bahadur, please.
Thank you so much. I really feel privileged talking about Dr. Arya and to honor his memory. My association with Dr. Arya started in 1961 when I joined Roorkee as a faculty, and he was a fellow faculty. But he was also my neighbor, so I knew him more socially than professionally. I practically saw Poonam and Arun grew up right from the childhood to the teenagers. So I feel very closely with that family. I'm not going to repeat whatever he has attained academically, because that has already been said and could be repeated. But what I'd like to say is that Dr. Arya was a very unique individual. While rising through all these heights in his professionally, he was able to maintain the simple ways of life, his great sense of humor. And although he didn't laugh too much, but whenever he liked a joke, he would laugh so heartily that even the neighbors would come out to ask as to what was so funny that Dr. Arya was laughing so loudly. His approach to friendship was so warm, and his relationship were so warm, that if you meet him once, it feels like you know him forever. And such qualities he continued all the way, although he had rose to such heights as most of us dream but never get there. One of the things that left a deep impression on me is a love for the society, his love for religion, his conviction, his principles, and his love for Roorkee campus. So it's only befitting that a man of Dr. Arya should be remembered through a chair that IIT Roorkee has decided to establish in his name, because he was not just a great intellectual person, he was also a very pragmatic philosopher, somebody who is a totally complete personality. So I don't want to take much time, because as people have said before, so much has been written about Dr. Arya on internet, in Google, in everywhere, wherever you go, you find Dr. Arya's reference. And I sometimes wonder that if Dr. Arya had not done so much of work, what the Google will have to write. So with that, I would like to close by saying that, Professor Gujar, I really appreciate that you sought me out. You gave me an opportunity to appreciate my friend, Dr. Arya, publicly. And Mr. Arya, it's so nice to see you. And next time when I come to India, I'll make sure to come and see you. Thank you so much. Thank you, Mr. Chaturvedi, also.
Thank you. Thank you, Professor Sher Bahadur. So Professor Sher Bahadur's words remind me the poem If of Rudyard Kipling, which expresses some aspects of Professor Arya, like, if you can talk with crowds and keep your virtue, or walk with kings nor lose the common touch, if neither foes nor loving friends can hurt you, if all men count with you but none too much. So this kind of personality was our great Professor Arya. Now I request Dr. Rajesh Kumar Mittal. He is nephew of Professor Arya, and he is also alumnus of IIT Roorkee. He did MSc in Physics from IIT Roorkee in 1980, and then PhD from IIT Delhi. And he recently retired from ONGC as Chief General Manager. I request Dr. Mittal, please share his thoughts.
Yeah, thank you, Professor Gujar. Respected Director IIT Roorkee, Professor Chaturvedi, and all distinguished guests present here. This is really a very proud moment for me for getting opportunity to say few words about my beloved Chacha Ji, Padam Shri Dr. A.S. Arya on this occasion. Dr. Arya was younger to my father in the family. In spite of our initial background from a small village, Ambetta in district Saharanpur, he rose to such a high level of international repute in the area of earthquake engineering. As we all know, Dr. Arya had set an example of completing his doctoral degree within a very record time of less than 2 years, that is 21 months only, from the University of Illinois. At the time of joining PhD in 1959, he was married, but had to leave his wife, Mrs. Arya, and little children alone in India during those days. This incident he used to tell me very frequently. So that's why I was sharing this incident. And therefore, the dedication and sacrifice of our beloved Chachi Ji also need to be acknowledged here. She is now the oldest surviving member of our big family. And in fact, Dr. Arya's success lies in the amalgamation of his hard work, sincerity, honesty, disciplined life, and full support from his beloved wife at every stage of his life, because of which he always had blessings of both Ma Saraswati and Lakshmi. From my childhood, I used to hear about his dedication towards his studies and family values from my parents also. I'll share one incident when a massive earthquake had struck in Bhuj in Gujarat in 2001. I was posted there in Ahmedabad. And he frequently visited Ahmedabad and Gandhinagar under an assignment given by Government of India for the rehabilitation work of Bhuj. So for which he was later awarded Padam Shri also, as we know, everybody knows. So during that time, my family also got an opportunity to interact with Dr. Arya and Mrs. Arya more closely. My both children were at the age of around 13 and 8 years at that time. That was the golden period for us to be near him and got another chance to learn more and more from his life. I last met him, Dr. Arya, in June 2019 in the marriage ceremony of his grandson at Hyderabad. At the age of around 88 years, he made it to attend the marriage function there. This showed his strong willpower and willingness to become part of all happy moments of the family. He was looking very cheerful at that time. From there also, I learned how to pay respect to family values by keeping strong willpower within ourselves. Although he is no more with us today, but his inspiration and love will remain in our hearts forever. Lastly, I am very much thankful for establishing a professor's chair on his name so that he will continue to be remembered for his contributions towards education and social welfare in the days to come, and will continue to inspire generation next. With this, thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Mittal. Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you, Dr. Mittal. So now I I introduce two of his children, eldest children, Mr. Arun Arya, the son. He did his B.Tech from IIT Kanpur in civil engineering and M.Tech in computer science from IIT Kanpur and a PhD from University of Rochester. He then worked at Bell Labs and taught at University of New Mexico and University of Massachusetts. Then we have with us Mrs. Poonam Agarwal. She is the second child and oldest daughter of Professor Arya. She is also an alumnus of IIT Roorkee. She did her BE in Electronics and Communications in 1977. And after that, she completed her master's from IIT Delhi in 1979. She worked in R&D of medical devices and earned more than 10 patents. She also worked for Medtronic Incorporation of USA and then retired early with the title of Distinguished Engineer in 2014 and worked as freelance consultants. Her spouse, Mr. Rakesh Agrawal, working as Director of Programs at Northrop Grumman. And they are blessed with one daughter who is a doctor and one son who is an electrical engineer. So now I request Mrs. Poonam Agrawal to kindly share her thoughts.
Afternoon and good morning. Sabko mera pranam. As you introduced me, my name is Poonam. I'm Professor Arya's eldest daughter. My father always had a great connection and love for University of Roorkee, and now IIT Roorkee. If I call it University of Roorkee, please forgive me, that's how I remember.
May I request Mrs. Poonam Agrawal to raise your voice or to keep your mic nearer so that we can hear properly? Yeah, please.
Okay. Sabko pranam. Main Poonam hoon. My father had a great connection and love for University of Roorkee, now IIT Roorkee, which I remember more as University of Roorkee when I was there. As we all know, he received his bachelor's degree and master's degree from this great institution, now about 173 years old, Thompson College of Engineering, then University of Roorkee, then IIT Roorkee. He received his doctoral degree from University of Illinois, USA, and finished his PhD in a record 22 months, so he could come back to his family who was waiting for him in India. He spent his entire academic career at the university. He has lectured and taught earthquake engineering in several institutions in India as well as abroad. Growing up, I remember my father was out of town a lot, and in those days, phones were not that good. So for a while, we won't have any news from him. And my mother very ably raised us children on her own when he was out and maintained the home. He also received numerous awards in India as well as recognition all over the world, notably for his contributions to disaster prevention. One noteworthy award I want to mention is the United Nations DHA Sasakawa Disaster Prevention Award in 1997. He donated the entire substantial prize money to his beloved University of Roorkee. If I remember, he didn't even buy a sari for my mom. He just donated all the money. His achievements are well known to you, very well documented. I would just like to mention a few things about my father, the man. He was a hardworking, brilliant, disciplined, soft-spoken, gentle, and kind soul. A loving and wonderful family man. He believed in early to bed, early to rise, daily yogasans, daily havans, working long hours. He had a well-situated home office always, where he worked before and after working at the university. Always woke up at 5:30 and went to sleep at 9:30. I remember when university folks would come to visit, some would come like at 9 after their late dinners. My father would be almost falling asleep on the sofa while talking to them. He was a true karma yogi, as Krishnaji said in Gita, actions, always actions for the benefit of his family, his extended family, and the good of humanity. He believed in India as a nation and the Indian culture. His solutions for disaster prevention were pragmatic and achievable at low cost using locally available material. He didn't believe in high-priced foreign materials that were needed. He established dispensaries based on Ayurvedic, Unani, and homeopathic practices and donated these to the state government. He donated tons of money annually to support polio operations through Narayan Seva Sanskar, education and buildings for Gurukul students studying Vedic Sanskriti. He established a school that's still being run with over 2,700 students and established an infrastructure for a girls-only school where nominal fees will be charged. The first time I realized how great my father was, I will tell you this. I was in school and our family, we were traveling with my father. He was going traveling within India on some business. And we stopped in one place at the guest house for the, and there was a very young, handsome assistant engineer. When he heard my father's name, he did Dandavat Pranam. He lay down in his feet. And I just looked at that. And he only read his books and he taught, he acted, he respected him as a guru just by reading his book and did Dandavat. And I was flabbergasted, overwhelmed. Okay, my father is great. I know that now. I don't know if many of you know, he sang so beautifully. I remember these picnics in Roorkee, in the boathouse there, where we would be with families, other families, maybe Sher Bahadur uncle remembers too. And my father will sing sometimes. And it was just so melodious and so beautiful. I will never forget that. I have those scenes in my mind all the time. I can go on and on, but we'll stop here in the interest of time. I do want to thank you, all the speakers. It was overwhelming to hear about my father. Especially Paritosh uncle, I don't know if you remember me. I remember you. And you just made me cry here. So anyway, establishing the chair at the UOR, as it was known, Roorkee IIT, is a continuation of his philanthropic principles and love for his alma mater. So very suitable. Thank you so much for letting me speak.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Mrs. Poonam Agrawal. Now I come to Dr. Subhas Agrawal. Dr. Subhas Agrawal is married to Professor Aryat's second daughter, Anjali, who is also an alumnus of IIT Roorkee. She completed her Bachelor of Engineering in Electronics and Communications in 1983. And I recall since last, 3-4 days, we are continuously exchanging messages, emails. She did so much hard work for this particular day. Thank you, Anjali ji. Dr. Subhas Agrawal received his BTEC in Electronics from WITS Pilani and Master's in Computer Science from Illinois Institute of Technology, Chicago, and PhD in Computer Science from Purdue University. He served as Vice President of Engineering at BMC Software and advises startups and venture capital firms on technology and strategy. I request Dr. Subhas Agrawal, please, to share his thoughts.
Thank you, Dr. Gurchar. Namaskar. And thank you for putting together this event. It really is truly wonderful to hear everyone's comments and get to know my papa much more than I've kind of known in the whole family. In some sense, While I've been married to Anjali since 1985, so it's been 35 years, because I have lived in US all this time, I probably know him the least well. So it really is delightful to hear everybody's compliments, the stories, really the experiences that everyone has had, and the words of affection coming from Bhandariji, Tyagiji, even Raviji, who has not gotten to know him only relatively recently, and Sher Bahadur uncle, who is in North Carolina, and maybe we'll get to visit with him sometime. So a lot has been talked about his accomplishment and the qualities as a person. And what I'm about to say is are the qualities that have been mentioned that I noticed, and share some anecdotes that really led to his success, along with the unwavering support of Amma, Mrs. Arya, without whose unconditional support and giving it all, I don't think he could have accomplished what he did. So the first quality that I would mention that he had was discipline. Professor Arya was very disciplined. He maintained a consistent routine and schedule day in and day out, as Poonam Didi just mentioned. And here's an interesting anecdote on that, that I got to witness it in the, my first few days of being introduced to the Arya family. And this was the day of my engagement with Anjali in the evening. The house was full of guests. Everybody's laughing, joking, and kind of 9:30 came. Papa got up, changed into the pajamas, comes in, says goodnight, and goes to bed, leaving the house full of guests to be attended to by Amma. So that felt pretty strange at that time. So what kind of person is he? After all the future son-in-law is at home, and I come from Rajasthan, it really felt weird. But as I've grown older, I have really begun to appreciate his discipline, that he woke up at the same time every day, did his yoga, havan, same time for breakfast, lunch, dinner, work, and bedtime. So I probably think that everybody in Roorkee set their clocks according to his schedule and the time. What it was that this discipline kept him in good health, gave him boundless energy, and he kept up this schedule even when he traveled overseas, adapted to new time zones without skipping a beat, and I did not see him suffer jet lag. He truly was indefatigable. Other thing, a word that comes to my mind when I think of him is practical. It has also been mentioned by others. So while he spent his life in an academic institution, he did not live in ivory tower and always focused on finding practical solutions to the problems at hand. This attitude is reflected in everything, as has been mentioned, in the rehabilitation and reconstruction of Bhuj after the earthquakes, developing the vulnerability management atlas and the like. And he kind of drove that point home to me one day as part of our conversation when he said, the best is an enemy of good. So he did not try to seek the best possible solution and the like, but so what's practical, what's doable, what's affordable. And that generally is good enough. And that was a message coming from him, resonated very well with me. And I keep reminding my wife, Anjali, of that all the time. So I can go on describing his other qualities, dedicated, down to earth, frugal. Anjali keeps telling him, buy a better car. No, his Wagner was enough for him. Very direct, generous, spiritual, but then we'll spend the whole evening and Dr. Gurja would be after me with a bat. So maybe all be inspired by the meaningful life he had, try to emulate some of his qualities, and may this Anand Swarup Arya Institute chairship motivate others to achieve and contribute in the manner Professor Arya did. Thank you.
If I can take a minute, because Subhash mentioned about the car issue, Papa kept the simplest made in India cars like Wagoner or other local brands. And I used to say, Papa, you give so much in charity. Can you please buy a little fancy car so when we come here, we can ride in it? And he said, oh, I have a wonderful car. There's no need to buy anything else. So that just speaks to his simplicity and frugality. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Subhashji and Anjaliji. Thank you very much. Now we request Anshuli Arya. Mrs. Anshuli is the youngest of Professor Arya's children. She received her Bachelor of Engineering in 1987 in Civil Engineering from IIT Roorkee itself and Master of Engineering from IIT Roorkee in 1989. In the same year, she joined Indian Administrative Services and she is currently Additional Secretary in Department of Telecommunications, Government of India. I request Anshuli ji to kindly share her thoughts and views.
आप सभी को नमस्कार. मेरी आवाज आ रही है ना? धन्यवाद. आज 4 बजे से जो पापा के नाम से मेमोरियल लेक्चर हुआ था उसमें इतने लोगों का जो मैंने ट्रिब्यूट देना देखा और जिस तरह उनके दिल से निकला, बड़े बड़े लोगों के आंखों में आंसू थे, तो मुझे लगा कि वाकई ईश्वर की बड़ी कृपा है कि मैं इस फैमिली में पैदा हुई हूँ. मेरी रुड़की की बहुत अच्छी यादें हैं. हमारा अपना घर था, पापा का एक सेट रूटीन था, सुबह 5 बजे से उठकर रात के 10 बजे तक या तो घर के ऑफिस में या अर्थक्वेक इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट में वो रहते थे और लगातार काम करते थे. वो हमेशा लिखते रहते थे और उनके चेहरे पे कभी टेंशन भी नहीं होती थी. ऐसा लगता था वो अपना काम बहुत एंजॉय करते हैं. और मेरे कुछ बैचमेट्स जो इंजीनियरिंग में पढ़ रहे थे वो घर आते थे कभी कभी, तो वो हमेशा पापा को लिखते हुए देखते थे. बड़ी सी हमारे घर में उनकी टेबल थी और बहुत सारी किताबें थी, बिल्कुल एक टिपिकल प्रोफेसर का जैसे कमरा होता है उस तरह का. तो मेरे एक बैचमेट ने मेरे से पूछा था, मुझे अभी तक याद है, कि तुमने कभी सोचा है कि अंकल ने कितने किलोमीटर अब तक लिख लिया है? क्योंकि लगातार उन दिनों कंप्यूटर वगैरह तो थे नहीं, वो लिखते ही रहते थे और उनकी राइटिंग इतनी साफ और इतनी सुंदर थी जैसे मोती के टांके हो. हम उसको देख के पूरे एक शीट पर बड़ी बड़ी कैलकुलेशंस और उनके जो जितने भी नंबर होते थे 1, 2, 3 बहुत सफाई से लिखे हुए रहते थे. तो अब ये जरूर है कि समय बदलता है. अब कुछ वर्ष से पापा का हाथ असेंशियल ट्रेमर से हिलने लगा था बहुत ज्यादा, फिर पार्किंसन हुआ था, लेकिन उन्होंने अपना जो जोश था वो नहीं छोड़ा था. अब वो टाइपिस्ट को डिक्टेट करते थे तो वो लिखता था. अंत के सालों में उनके हाथ की समस्या थी पर उससे उन्होंने अपना जीवन प्रभावित नहीं होने दिया. और इसमें मैं कहूंगी कि हमारी मम्मी का बहुत बड़ा योगदान है. उन्होंने पापा की बहुत बहुत देखभाल की अंतिम समय तक, पूरा समय अपना. बाद में तो शायद उनकी कोई इसके अलावा लाइफ ही नहीं थी कि सुबह से रात तक पापा की देखभाल करना. उन्हें बहुत दवाइयां देनी होती थी समय पे, खाने की बहुत देखभाल करनी पड़ती थी. तो लेकिन इससे हमारे घर में किसी को ये नहीं था कि कोई दिक्कत है. पापा बहुत खुश रहते थे और ईश्वर में उनका विश्वास था, जो मेरे अंदर भी शायद मम्मी पापा की वजह से आया है, कि समय एक जैसा नहीं होता. समय में आपको दिक्कतें भी आती हैं लेकिन आपको उनसे हारना नहीं है. उन्होंने कभी डिप्रेशन शब्द का इस्तेमाल अपने लिए नहीं किया. आजकल एक फैशन है कि कुछ भी होता है, खैर डिप्रेशन एक बीमारी है, इसको सीरियसली भी लेते हैं, लेकिन लोग उसको एज एक्रोनिम या ऐसे भी बोलते रहते हैं, डिप्रेशन हो गया, पर उनकी शब्दावली में ये शब्द नहीं था. कितनी दिक्कतें आई फिजिकली इमोशनली, वो कभी उन्होंने हार नहीं मानी. और मैं एक छोटी सी बात और कहना चाहूंगी, पापा का जो बिहार डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट अथॉरिटी में उनका कार्यकाल रहा, उसकी बातें लोगों को ज्यादा पता नहीं है क्योंकि दिल्ली की बातें ज्यादा होती हैं। मैं छोटी बात कहूंगी कि उनको नीतीश कुमार जी ने कैसे मेंबर बनाया। आदरणीय नीतीश कुमार जी ने एक बार एक मौका हुआ कि उन्होंने पापा का प्रेजेंटेशन देखा, सुना, डायस पे नेचुरली वो भी थे और पापा भी साइड में थे। जब पापा प्रेजेंटेशन देने खड़े हुए तो नीतीश कुमार जी ऑडियंस में आके बैठ गए। उनको इतना अच्छा प्रेजेंटेशन लगा कि उन्होंने समझने के लिए वो उल्टी तरफ ऑडियंस में आके बैठ गए जिससे अच्छे से समझे, और प्रेजेंटेशन पापा का लगभग एक घंटा चला और उसके बाद उन्होंने तुरंत कहा कि हम ये हमारे यहाँ मेंबर बनेंगे बीएसडीएमए में। और पापा को 85 साल तक, जब तक पापा में चलने फिरने की रही कि वो यहाँ से पटना जा सकते हैं दिल्ली से, उन्होंने उनको मेंबर रखा। उसके लिए सारे नियम कानून वहां पे उन्होंने कैबिनेट में ले जाकर रिलैक्स कराए गए। और पापा ने वहां पे काम भी बहुत किया, अनिल सिन्हा जी साथ रहे उनके, और वहां पे एक ऐसा संयोग हुआ कि मैं सेक्रेटरी बिल्डिंग डिपार्टमेंट थी, बिल्डिंग कंस्ट्रक्शन डिपार्टमेंट, और 2015 का अर्थक्वेक आया, नेपाल अर्थक्वेक, जिसमें बिहार भी बहुत प्रभावित हुआ था। तो बिहार में बिल्डिंग्स गिरी नहीं थी लेकिन क्रैक्स आ गए थे, और जो पटना में मल्टी स्टोरीड हैं उनके बारे में लोगों को डर भी है कि कैसी बनी होंगी, तो यदि वो हिली एक तो बहुत, और जरा भी क्रैक आया तो लोग पैनिक हो गए और सब निकल निकल के बाहर आ गए कि अब हम घर में वापस नहीं जाएंगे। और उसके बाद आफ्टर शॉक्स भी आ रहे थे, तो मुख्यमंत्री जी के यहाँ इतने फोन पे फोन गए, उन्होंने फटाफट मीटिंग बुलाई कि अब इसमें क्या करना है, लोगों को कैसे हम एजुकेट करें। तो मुझे पता था कि पापा है वहां पे, तो मैंने कहा कि सर पापा इसका रास्ता बताएंगे, आप मुझे 10 मिनट दीजिए। मैंने पापा से बात की, उन्होंने कहा कि इसमें कोई दिक्कत नहीं है, इसकी श्रेणी होती है बिल्डिंग में G1 से G4, हमने गुजरात में यूज की है और मैंने उसका सब बना रखा है, उसकी हम ट्रेनिंग दे देते हैं इंजीनियर्स को अभी, और इससे हम लोगों को जागरूक करेंगे। आप विश्वास नहीं करेंगे कि जो पटना के सभी विभागों के इंजीनियर्स थे, उन्होंने एक घंटे में उसकी G1 से G2 से G3 G4 में कैसे आप क्रैक्स से ये निकालेंगे कि बिल्डिंग में कोई खतरा है या बिल्डिंग में खाली क्रैक्स दिख रहे हैं लेकिन खतरा नहीं है, आप रह सकते हैं। इस तरह की स्टडी का एक घंटे में उन्होंने पटना के इंजीनियर्स को ट्रेनिंग दी, क्योंकि मुख्यमंत्री जी खुद थे तो इंजीनियर्स भी बहुत उन्होंने सावधानी से अच्छे से सब सुना, और हम लोगों ने रात में ही टीम्स बना बना के डिफरेंट मोहल्लों में निकाल दी क्योंकि पटना में सबसे ज्यादा पैनिक था। अगले दिन से हमने प्रत्येक जिले के इंजीनियर्स को, पापा ने स्वयं वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंसिंग के द्वारा, स्वान नेटवर्क के द्वारा सबको ट्रेनिंग दी। और पापा का बताने का तरीका इतना सरल था कि जो इंजीनियर्स बहुत ब्राइट नहीं है, और इवन जो सिविल इंजीनियर्स नहीं थे, क्योंकि इंजीनियर्स कम थे, आवश्यकता ज्यादा थी, तो और अलाइड सर्विसेज के इंजीनियर्स को भी ग्रुप में बिठा बिठा के और लगातार 3-4 दिन तक वीडियो के माध्यम से हम लोगों ने ट्रेन किया। पापा बैठे रहते थे ट्रेनिंग में, और उसका ये असर रहा कि पैनिक सिचुएशन खत्म हो गई। अदरवाइज अर्थक्वेक में इतना नुकसान नहीं हुआ था जितना पैनिक से हो जाता नुकसान। मतलब बड़े बड़े जज अपनी कोठी छोड़ के आ गए थे कि हमें डर है कि ये गिर जाएगी। तो ये मुझे एक मेरा गोल्डन पीरियड रहा, और यहाँ मुझे लगा कि टेक्नोलॉजी और जो एग्जीक्यूटर्स हैं, हम लोग जो पॉलिसी को इम्प्लीमेंट करते हैं, इसका मेल अगर हो जाए तो कितना आसानी से काम हो सकता है। बस मैं ये दो बातें कह के अपनी बात समाप्त करती हूँ, और यूनिवर्सिटी IIT रुड़की के सभी हमारे डायरेक्टर साहब को और आप सभी को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद इस चेयर को स्थापित करने के लिए, बहुत धन्यवाद।
Thank you very much. Now I request Mrs. Kausalya Devi Arya, who has been the real powerhouse of the Arya family. She is deeply spiritual and generous philanthropist. Her philanthropy is much appreciated by many NGOs. She took all the family responsibilities and ensured Professor Arya from other responsibilities freedom, enough freedom, so that he could pursue his research and academic interest and serve the society. I request Mrs. Kausalya Devi Arya, please.
सभी उपस्थित महानुभावों को मेरा सादर अभिवादन. डॉक्टर आर्य को पद्मश्री मिली या सोशाकावा अवार्ड मिला या फिक्की अवार्ड मिला या बुक्स लिखी, ये 4 बजे से आप सबने ही बहुत श्रद्धा पूर्वक आदर पूर्वक और प्रेम पूर्वक बता दिया. अब विषय को बदलते हुए थोड़े से लम्हे जो मैंने उनके साथ काटे, थोड़े से पल जो दृष्टि के बिताए, केवल उनके बारे में ही बात करती हूँ. मुझे गर्व है कि मुझे डॉक्टर आनंद स्वरूप आर्य की पत्नी बनने का सौभाग्य मिला. उनका जीवन पूर्णतया सादगी और अनुशासन से भरपूर रहा. जब हमारी शादी हुई थी उसके बाद मैंने उनको, जब से मैं उनसे मिली या देखा, कभी भी खाली बैठकर गपशप करते या आलस्य में पड़ा हुआ मैंने उन्हें कभी नहीं देखा. हर समय लिखना पढ़ना जैसा एंजॉय करने का एकमात्र साधन उनका गुण था. हमेशा ही तीज त्योहार हो, दीपावली हो, होली हो और कोई पर्व हो, कोई भी दिन ऐसा नहीं जाता था जो भी टाइम मिलता था वो अपनी टेबल पर बैठ के सामना करते हो और स्लाइड रूल ना चलाते हो या पढ़ाई ना करते हो. रिसर्च तो उनका एक सपना था, क्योंकि जैसे ही मैं शादी होकर आई थी उन्होंने 2-4 दिन के बाद ही मुझसे कहा कि मेरा एक सपना है, वो है रिसर्च. मुझे आशा है कि उसमें तुम मेरा साथ दो, क्योंकि उनको एंजॉय करने का जो तरीका था वो काम करना ही, उनका पढ़ना लिखना ही एंजॉय करने का. उनके साथ एक बार हम गए उनके साथियों के साथ तो उन्होंने कहा कि भाई आनंद तो किताबों का कीड़ा है, भाभी जी आपकी एक सोच भी है. मैं समझ नहीं पाई. उन्होंने कहा आपको पता नहीं चला अब तक आपकी एक सोच है, किताबें सोच है आपकी. तो इस तरह का उनका जीवन था. मैंने उनको कभी गुस्सा करते नहीं देखा, छोटे हों या बड़े हों, जिससे जो गलती होती थी उसको वो सुधारने का प्रयत्न करते थे लेकिन कभी भी गुस्सा नहीं करते थे. और फिर मेरे से विचार विमर्श करते थे कि किस तरह से उसकी समस्या दूर हो. मुझे लगता था कि गलती उसकी है और डिस्कस कर रहे कि उसको किस तरह परेशानी से हटाया जावे, अजीब भी लगता था. लेकिन उनकी आदत ऐसी थी कि किसी के लिए गुस्सा आता ही नहीं था. घर में हमेशा ही पढ़ाई का माहौल रहने के कारण हमारे 4 बच्चे भी उच्च शिक्षा प्राप्त कर सके. मैंने सदैव कोशिश की जीवन के हर मोड़ पर मैं उनके साथ कंधे से कंधा मिलाकर खड़ी रहूं और हर सुख दुख के पलों को एक साथ मिलकर बिताऊं. मेरे पति एक आदर्श व्यक्ति थे, इससे मेरा मुझे हमेशा ही खुशी मिलती रही. हर पल मैंने जीवन को ऐसा जिया कि बहुत गर्व के साथ जिया कि आज ये साथ जैसे मेरे पति मिले. उनकी हर सफलता में मैं गर्व महसूस करती रही. एक पत्नी को अपने पति से जो अपेक्षाएं होती हैं मुझे उससे कुछ ज्यादा ही मिला, कम नहीं मिला. एक सफल वैज्ञानिक के साथ साथ उनकी जो दूसरी प्रेफरेंस थी, दूसरे उनको जिसमें आनंद मिलता था वो सामाजिक कार्य थे. उनका मस्तिष्क में एक बहुत अच्छी तरह ये बैठा हुआ था कि हमारे बच्चों में संस्कार नहीं पड़ते, किसी भी तरह से ऐसा माहौल बनाया जाए कि जो बच्चों में अच्छे संस्कार पड़े. इसीलिए उन्होंने एक इंटर कॉलेज का निर्माण किया जिसमें 3,000 बच्चे इस समय पढ़ रहे हैं और बहुत ही बच्चों में राष्ट्र प्रेम और संस्कार पड़े हुए हैं. यही नहीं, जाने से कुछ दिन पहले ही 3 डिस्पेंसरीज का भी निर्माण कराया और उनको सरकार को दिया जिससे गरीब को मुफ्त में दवा मिल सके, इलाज हो सके. मेरे पति का सदैव ही IIT रुड़की से आत्मीयता का रिश्ता रहा. मेरी 3 बेटी वहीं पढ़ी हैं. उनका सारा जीवन, हालांकि रेलवे में सिलेक्शन हो गया था लेकिन जैसा बताया गया कि उन्होंने आरितोष त्यागी जो उनके मित्र हैं, उन्होंने आप शुरू में बताया था कि वो उसमें नहीं गए, तो उनका जो था केवल सर्च में ध्यान था, उनका ध्यान दूसरी तरफ था ही नहीं। तो मेरे पति का सदैव से ही आईआईटी रुड़की में आत्मीयता का रिश्ता रहा है, इसलिए उनके बच्चे के सपनों को साकार करने के लिए आईआईटी रुड़की को दान देने में मुझे खुशी महसूस। संस्थान के निदेशक प्रोफेसर चतुर्वेदी जी और रजिस्ट्रार श्री भोला राय गुजर तथा आईआईटी के सभी अधिकारीगण को मैं धन्यवाद देती हूँ जिन्होंने इस कार्यक्रम का आयोजन किया। धन्यवाद देती हूँ और मुझे आशा है सर चेयर की स्थापना से मेरे पति का योगदान हमेशा जिंदा रहे और ये मेरे सपनों का साकार है। आज के दिन मेरा ये कठिन है, मेरा मन भी भरा है क्योंकि मुझे ये सौभाग्य भी मिला जाते जाते कि मेरे पति का नाम हमेशा के लिए रहेगा कभी। थैंक यू, सबको नमस्कार, थैंक यू वेरी मच।
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद मिसेज आर्या जी, आपने बहुत ही सही बात कही कि गलती को भी आर्या साहब कभी टोकते नहीं थे। मुझे खुद का एक निजी अनुभव याद आता है, एक दिन रात को फोन आया और हमने जब एक नई सिस्टम शुरू किया कि डोनर्स को हम फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट भेजते हैं हर साल, तो उन्होंने स्पेशली फ़ोन करके कहा कि भाई आपने ये बहुत अच्छी शुरुआत की है और उसमें एक छोटी मिस्टेक थी, उसमें थोड़ी गलती थी, उसको भी उन्होंने बड़े प्यार से सुधारने के लिए बताया कि यहाँ पे ये लगता है कि एंट्री में गलती हो गई है, आप देख लीजिएगा। तो वाकई उनका स्वभाव बहुत ही संत स्वभाव जैसा था। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद इन उद्गारों के लिए। अब मैं रिक्वेस्ट करता हूँ हमारे संस्थान के निदेशक श्री अजीत कुमार चतुर्वेदी जी से कि वो चेयर के बारे में दो शब्द कहें और इस महत्वपूर्ण मौके पर अपने विचार व्यक्त करें।
आदरणीय श्रीमती कौशल्या देवी आर्य जी, आपके बहुत भावनात्मक आपने जो उद्गार व्यक्त किए बिल्कुल दिल को छू गए, और जो आज शाम से एक समा बंधा है 4 बजे से, वो बहुत ही जिसे कहते हैं कि एक ऐसा लग रहा है कि इतना प्रभावशाली सूरज की तरह चमकने वाला व्यक्तित्व और चांद जैसी शीतलता वाला व्यक्तित्व दोनों जिसमें हो, कि जिसमें इतना तेज हो, इतना इतना कर्मठ हो, इतना कर्मयोगी हो और साथ में इतना अच्छा व्यक्ति हो कि इतने अच्छे से लोग याद कर रहे हैं, इतने प्यार से लोग याद कर रहे हैं, इसका मतलब कितना कितने बड़े थे हमारे प्रोफेसर आर्या, ये इससे अंदाज लगाया जा सकता है। तो मैं सभी को यहाँ पे इस समारोह में सभी का, आर्या फैमिली का, पूरी आर्या फैमिली का बहुत बहुत स्वागत करता हूँ, और जो मित्र हैं, जो उनके साथ काम करने वाले कलीग्स हैं, फ्रेंड्स हैं, उन सबका भी इसमें स्वागत करता हूँ। इन सम सेंस आई वुड से दैट आई एम द ऑड मैन आउट। I guess you would understand why I'm saying that, but then I will clear my doubt if you have understood that what I meant and in what sense I am not the odd man out. So let me explain this paradox. So I am probably the only person who has not met him physically. So in that sense I am the odd man out. But why am I saying it's a paradox? Because I was fortunate to have talked to him over the phone. And then I have treasured 3 emails from him. In fact, today evening, just before this function, I searched those emails and I was able to get all those 3 emails. And he wrote signed letters to me let me tell you the anecdote. So what happened, I joined in 2017 in IIT Roorkee. And then in July, month of July, we welcomed the new students. And then in that new students, we had a slot for Guru Darshan. That was some former teacher, some celebrity would come and talk about, sort of inspire the students to think about the society, country, and pursue education. So we requested Professor Arya. Of course, I did not know him, but I was suggested that Professor Arya could be the person, and we were very happy to invite him for that. And he readily agreed. But what happened just a day before the event, I think there was some problem in his, he wrote a very detailed explanation in his letter that because of osteoporosis, there was a fracture in one of the lumbar spines, L3, he said was collapsed, and because of which he could not travel from Delhi to Roorkee. And so he was very profusely sort of, he regretted that he was not able to come. And I missed an opportunity to actually meet him physically. And he not only sent the email, but also followed up by making a phone call to me. And I remember that phone call. And after that, on two more occasions, we exchanged emails. But I'm there, in that sense, I'm the unfortunate one who never had the opportunity to meet him physically. Today is a very historic and memorable day from many angles. I would share the angle which probably has not been mentioned today evening. This journey of institute chair professorships started in 2017 when IIT Roorkee instituted this institute chair professorships, which were a notch higher than the other chair professorships. And today is the third chair which is getting inaugurated in that series. But what is special is that this is the first chair which is going to be named after an alumni or after a faculty. And I always speak, when I speak from public podiums and public functions, then I always I continue to say this, that we have to recognize our heroes, we have to talk about our role models, and we have to do something so that we can perpetuate the memory of these role models and heroes. And who else can sort of fit that bill other than Professor Arya? So I'm very extremely delighted that this evening has come today, when we have an institute chair professor in the name of an alumni, in the name of faculty. And what makes it doubly special is that the chair is sponsored also by alumni. So I mean, it sort of completes the circle, because many times you have somebody else donating, or you have somebody, the name in his memory the chair is instituted, that person is not an alumni. But in this case, it's everything is covered. And when you have somebody who is so well known that the chair, the occupant of the chair, it will add glory to that person. Everybody will get to know about him. They would like to learn more about his work. And I'm sure that this work, Mrs. Kaushalya Devi and all others have described, morning 5 a.m. to evening 9 p.m. for so many years, a life that was 80 plus, so much work that has been done, and so much has been written. In fact, Anshuli ji was saying that how many kilometers has been written. So all that will translate into a foundation on which we will build a big edifice. On this occasion, unfortunately, Shri Mohinder Nayyar ji is unable to join. I would be failing in my duty if I do not thank Shri Mohinder Nayyar, the founder of the IIT Roorkee Foundation in US. If this foundation was not there, today evening this function would not have been possible. Because of Shri Mohinder Nayyar, who established this IIT Roorkee Foundation, that we are able to do this function. I profusely thank the entire family, all the three daughters, the sons-in-law, the son, and of course, respected Shrimati Kaushalya Devi ji, that you have been so generous, you have been so kind, that you to carry forward the philanthropic work that Professor Arya did all his life. And even after he is not there with us, you thought that it will be befitting his memory that you institute this chair in the institute he loved so well, so much. As was mentioned by Bhandari ji in the beginning, very many people have written messages to me, none other than the former chief of army staff, N.C. Vij. He has written a message. The president of the Indian National Academy of Engineering, Dr. Sanat Mishra, he has written a message. And I would specially like to read out two paragraphs of a message written by Dr. P.K. Mishra. Right. So I want to read out two paragraphs which I thought sort of they summarize very well what so many people have been talking about since today afternoon. So this is from Dr. P.K. Mishra, who is the principal secretary to the Prime Minister. He writes that Professor Arya was a people's engineer. He was a pioneer in taking scientific and engineering knowledge to the people. With modest resources, over several decades, he did path-breaking work, whether it was in the form of one of the first manuals of non-engineered earthquake-resistant construction, or in the form of indigenously designed shock table for experimental work at the Earthquake Engineering Department at IIT Roorkee. While there were many firsts to his name, first Indian laureate of the Union Sasakawa Award or Padma Shri for his contributions to disaster risk management, in my view, his most enduring contribution was in inspiring and mentoring at least two generations of disaster risk management professionals in the country who continue to follow in his footsteps. Whether it is his work after Latur earthquake or after Bhuj earthquake, wherever he worked with a lot of care and affection and direct personal involvement, he nurtured young people working in this field. In a sense, his work continues to manifest itself through hundreds of younger people he coached and prepared. I would like to end by making a solemn pledge in front of all of you. And that pledge is that we will double our efforts to make sure that the Earthquake Engineering Department of IIT Roorkee becomes the guiding light for not only India, but for the entire South Asia, and if possible, for the entire developing world. We pledge that on this occasion, when you have come forward, we will go ahead and achieve this objective within finite time frame. I again thank the Arya family profusely from my heart. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Professor Chaturvedi. Now I request Professor Manoranjan Parida, Deputy Director of IIT Roorkee, to please deliver the vote of thanks.
Thank you, Professor Gurjar. Respected Mrs. Kausalya Devi Arya and family members of Professor Arya, his friends, colleagues, Dr. R.K. Bhandari, Mr. Paritosh Tyagi, Professor Ravi Sinha from IIT Bombay, Professor A.K. Mathur, Professor Thakkar, Professor Sher Bahadur, and all the attendees of this particular event. It's a great event in the establishment of AS Arya Institute Chair Professorship. I am really thankful on behalf of me and on behalf of the Institute to the entire Arya family for establishing this particular chair professorship. So this is going to be really extremely useful, as Professor Chaturvedi has taken a place that at IIT Roorkee we are trying to strengthen all the efforts related to this particular area. This, although it's an institute chair professorship, but yes, it speaks of our commitment to the different areas in which Professor Arya worked. I say that to start with disaster mitigation and management, earthquake engineering, civil engineering in general, and his role in social service and professional practice. And anybody who is going to occupy this chair will have a great challenge to continue the legacy, because the expectations are going to be very, very high. Professor Chaturvedi talked about such chairs are like creating a role model to make us understand that how important different values are going to be as part of a great academics. And I would also like to extend a warm welcome to all of you. Maybe sometimes when you can visit physically, because of a very close time, we could not have the function, a physical function. Maybe next year, 1st September 2021, we can have a physical program where a lecture can be organized physically. So I extend all the members, all the colleagues of Professor Arya to visit us physically. And we extend warm invitation to all of you. And once again, I thank all of you for sharing your thoughts. And I know that you have shared very valuable inputs. Many of them, they are truly emotional thoughts. I cannot respond them in a very limited time, but I do respect all your sentiments, all the ideas, all the thoughts which has been shared by Professor Arya. Once again, I extend my tribute to Professor A.S. Arya, and thank you all for joining this evening for the establishment of this Institute Chair of establishment of this AS Arya Institute Chair Professorship. Thank you, Professor Gurjar.
Thank you very much. Thanks to all and one. And again, we express our gratitude to the Arya family and his friends and colleagues who have taken time to join this particular event in his honor and memory. Thank you very much.